When a 5.3 quake rattled Wellington and Nelson this week, some of us got a warning message before we even felt it. New Zealand's one of only two countries trialling Google's new early warning system, and scientists are working on a model that could be rolled out for the whole country. Kristen Hall reports.
A familiar shake-up for Wellington earlier this week.
Oh, I was in the hospital, so I felt it on the third floor.
Maybe lasts for like 10 seconds, then it just disappeared.
And thanks to our phones, some of us knew the quake was coming before the ground began to wobble.
They received a warning time before incoming shaking from that earthquake. The public got quite excited and they were very enthusiastic about receiving that kind of warning.
It's part of a trial being carried out by Google in Greece and New Zealand that provides an alert a precious few seconds before shaking can be felt by humans.
So when an earthquake starts, it sends two types of waves. It sends a first set of waves that are quite small, but they're really fast. And so lucky for us, we can capture those waves.
The Google trial is only for Android phones at the moment, but Kiwi scientists are working to figure out how every New Zealander can get early earthquake alerts in future. Although it may come from a device like this placed in your home rather than from the phone in your pocket.
The devices we are looking at are actually dedicated to detect ground motion. They are kind of better compared to what you get in your mobile devices.
It could take some time though. It took more than a decade to develop the early warning models in place in the US and Japan.
I'm really keen that we think about our vulnerable populations as well. Physically, they may not be able to access these high-end technology.
Scientists working on the project say even a short advanced warning could save lives, providing time to drop, cover and hold, or protect transport.
They can actually slow train, stop elevator between levels and so on.
A valuable bit of tech for the shaky aisles. Kristen Hall, One News.